Morris Day. Let's sit comfortably here, nice and tall. Relax your shoulders. Close your eyes, and we'll start with one Om. Inhale. Taking those deep, steady breaths, start to bring your awareness to your breathing. So we're slowing our breath down and deepening it. Checking in with your body here, just noticing how you're feeling. Acknowledging any fatigue or soreness. Taking care of those things as we go. So if there are any poses that don't work today, we just don't do them, and that's okay. We can come back to something else that was comfortable. And let's practice today with this theme of honesty or trust and truth. So in life, we kind of know what that means. We don't lie, right, to people. But we can also have that same trust and that honesty with ourselves. So on the mat, we can practice this by being honest about the poses that maybe aren't right for us today. So sometimes if we get a little bit competitive with ourselves, we might try to force ourselves into poses that we're not ready for or that don't feel right. And so by practicing this honesty, this truth, we can tell ourselves it's okay to come back to something else, to back off a little bit. And the same goes the other way. If we're feeling like we're just giving ourselves an easy way out, maybe, instead of holding for that extra breath, even when we're totally capable of it, we might say, oh, I need to rest, and maybe that's not honest. So it's finding that line about being honest with your body in both directions, not pushing too hard, but also allowing yourself to be challenged. With that in mind, let's start by chanting the Gayatri Mantra together. We can bring our hands back over our hearts. Om Bhurbhuvah Swaha Tat Savitur-Vareeniyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Swaha Tat Savitur-Vareeniyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Swaha Tat Savitur-Vareeniyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Swaha Tat Savitur-Vareeniyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Swaha Tat Savitur-Vareeniyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Swaha Tat Savitur-Vareeniyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Swaha Tat Savitur-Vareeniyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yo Na Prachodayat. Om Bhurbhuvah Swaha Tat
Tat savitur vareniam, vargo devasya dimahi, diyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasvaha, tat savitur vareniam, vargo devasya dimahi, diyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasvaha, tat savitur vareniam, vargo devasya dimahi, diyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasvaha, tat savitur vareniam, vargo devasya dimahi, diyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasvaha, tat savitur vareniam, vargo devasya dimahi, diyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasvaha, tat savitur vareniam, vargo devasya dimahi, diyo yo na prachodayat.
Being truthful about what feels good to us and what's right for us on the mat today, let's take our hands to our side and with an inhale, bring them up above the head, timing that breath to your movement. Exhale, bring them down. Inhale up. This time exhale, right hand comes down, reach up and over to that right side. Inhale up. Exhale, other side. Inhale up. Exhale, right. Inhale up. Exhale, left. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, exhale. On the next inhale, come back up. And this time exhale, twist. Inhale back to center. And exhale, twist, other way. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, one more time each way, exhale. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, bring that back to center, and exhale, bring your hands down over your heart and start to fold forward here over your legs gently, bringing your palms down, maybe your elbows.
Inhale, bring it back up.
Bring your hands behind you, palms on the floor, fingers forward, and then lift your hips. Might not be high, that's okay. Do whatever feels good. And bring them down. We'll switch the fold or the cross of our legs here, and then fold forward again.
Bring it back up.
Hands behind you, fingers forward, and let's lift. Good, lower down. And we'll come onto our hands and knees here. Placing the knees right under the hips, wrists under the shoulders, fingers spread wide. Let's inhale to arch, Marjorie, the cat. Exhale, rounding.
Inhale.
And exhale, timing your breath to your movement. We'll keep going, a few more just like it. Last one right here. Finish that exhale and then come back to your neutral spine. And from there, let's sit back to that child pose, all the way back to your heels. We'll reach our arms forward here. Remembering this is a great place to come back to anytime in the practice that you need to find your breath or to slow down. Let's curl our toes under, lift the hips up to that first mountain pose. Remembering here, it's early. Feel free to let your knees bend. Let your heels move down toward the floor, but keep lifting those sit bones. Keep moving your heart toward your knees. Fingers spread wide. Walk our feet up toward our hands here, pausing in a forward fold just for a moment. Again, knees can stay soft. And we'll inhale all the way up to stand. Let's bring the palms down over the heart. Settle into Tadasana in preparation here for classical sun salutations. And then we'll move into some sun salutations with variation. Shoulders over hips, over ankles, knees are soft, unlocked. Inhale, arms up, heart up, little back bend if it feels good. And exhale, dive forward. Inhale, right foot steps back, low lunge. Hold the breath just for the left foot to plank. And then exhale, knees, chest, and chin to the floor. Inhale, cobra, shoulders down and back. Exhale, mountain. Inhale, right foot steps forward, left knee down, low lunge. Exhale, left foot forward, forward fold. Inhale, all the way up, a little bit of a back bend. Exhale, palms over heart. And the other side, inhale. Exhale,
dive forward. Inhale, left leg back, low lunge. Hold just for the right leg, and then exhale, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, cobra. And exhale, mountain. Inhale, left foot forward, low lunge. Exhale, right. Inhale, all the way up. Exhale, palms over heart. Again, inhale. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, right leg back, low lunge. Hold for the left, and then exhale, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, mountain. Inhale, right foot forward, left knee down, low lunge. Exhale, left foot forward. Inhale, all the way up. Little back bend, exhale, hands over heart. Other side, inhale. And exhale, dive forward. Inhale, left leg back. Hold the breath for the right, and then exhale, knees, chest, chin. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, mountain. Inhale, left foot forward, right knee down, low lunge. Exhale, right foot forward. Inhale to stand. And exhale, palms over heart. Let's add some variation. Inhale, lift. Remember, you can keep doing the same thing. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, right foot back. High lunge this time. Knee stays up. Hold the breath just for the left, and then exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward dog. Exhale, mountain, and go ahead and hold it here. Three breaths. And on the next inhale, let's lift the right leg up high behind us. And exhale, bring it down so the knee is on the floor in line with your right hand. So the right foot is going to kickstand out. The left foot steps over to be in line with the knee and the hand. And we'll lift that left arm up into our kneeling side plank just for a moment here. Nice steady breathing. And then like someone's holding your left hand, we're going to come all the way up here. Bring those hands together overhead. You can clasp them. And we'll lean to that side in the prayer moon gate. Next inhale, bring it back up. Exhale, right hand back down to the floor. Take a deep breath in here. And then exhale, let's bring the left hand down, turn to face the floor again in plank, and step your right foot all the way up. From there on the inhale, step forward left into an extended forward fold, and exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise, little back bend, and exhale, palms over heart. Other side, inhale. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, left foot back, high lunge. Hold for the right. Exhale, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Inhale, cobra, or up dog. And exhale, mountain. Let's hold the mountain. Fingers spread wide, nice steady breath, lifting those sit bones. With your next inhale, lift the left leg high. Exhale, step it down in line, so your knee's in line with the left hand. Slide that right foot over so it's in line as well. Left foot is kickstanded behind you, and the right arm is up. Kneeling side plank for just a moment. And then leading with that top hand to come up. We'll bring the hands together overhead again. Same thing, clasp them together. Reach them up high and then lean over. Good to that half moon gate here. Using your bottom arm to really stretch the top arm. And again, being honest and truthful about what is right for your body today. So that might mean taking this hand to your hip and leaning like so, or even resting it lightly on your leg. Good, next inhale, come up tall. Exhale, bring that left hand down to the floor. Let's take one in-breath here. And then exhale, return to plank. We'll step that left foot all the way up. On the inhale, step forward right into extended forward fold. And then exhale, forward fold. Inhale, bring it all the way up, little back bend. Exhale, palms over heart. New variation, inhale up. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, right foot steps back, high lunge. Hold for the left, and then exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, mountain, hold your mountain. This time on your inhale, we're coming to a plank and we're going to move to a side plank on the right. So you may choose to bring your right knee down just like we did before, or just come onto the outer edge of that right foot and lift your left arm up high. Finding your breath, your stability here, keeping the hips lifting up. On your next exhale, let's bring that hand back down nice and slow. Control that transition. Then step forward with the right foot. Forward with the left on the inhale to extended forward fold. And exhale, forward fold. Let's hold this forward fold here. Next inhale, we'll rise up, little back bend. Exhale, palms over heart. Other side, inhale. Exhale. Inhale, left foot steps back, high lunge. Hold for the right, and then exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, mountain, hold that mountain. Next. next inhale, come to plank. Choosing perhaps the kneeling plank on the left, or just coming onto the outer edge of that left foot, lifting the right arm up, keeping the hips lifted, holding here, breathing, slow, steady breath. And on the next exhale, slowly with control, bring that back down. Stepping forward with the left foot. And then on the inhale, stepping forward right to extended forward fold. Exhale, forward fold. And again, go ahead and hold it, maybe deepening it by holding your big toes, moving those elbows out to the side, letting the crown of your head really come down. With your next inhale, we'll come up. Palms together, little back bend, and then exhale, hands over the heart. Good, pausing in Tadasana here. Shoulders down, back. I'm just going to turn so you can see me, but you can stay right there at the front of your mat. Look down and see if you can spread your toes wide. Give yourself a nice strong base against the floor. Steady breath. With your next inhale, let's bring those hands up. Let them clasp together if that's comfortable. And we're going to exhale into Chandrasana or moon pose. So reaching your arms up and over. So the bottom arm again is straightening to reach the top arm, to stretch the top arm. Again, if it's too much, just being honest with our bodies today, we can bring that hand to the hip and give ourselves a little more support, or even let the arm rest here, a little bit easier that way, a little bit gentler. On the next inhale, let's arise and switch. So we're coming the other way as we exhale, again, reaching up and over. On the next inhale, bring it back up. And exhale, let the arms come down and let's fold forward just for a second here, but let your head and shoulders go. And let's do a little sway from side to side. Coming back to center. Next inhale, let's bring it back up. Bring the hands together again overhead, clasp them, the other thumb on top this time maybe. And we're going to lean again to the right. And from here, you can stay or we can work on that balance by shifting our weight to the left foot and letting the right foot float up. Good, next inhale, bring it up tall, foot down. Exhale the other way. First find that arc and then start to shift your weight right, lift the left. On the next inhale, bring it back up. And then exhale, let it go. Dive forward, forward fold. Again, holding that forward fold nice and easy. On the next inhale, take a step back with your left foot, placing the toes so they point out to the side. We'll come all the way up. Both legs are straight. And then reach forward as you shift the hip back, coming down to triangle, Trikonasana. So you may rest your hand or your elbow up high, give yourself a little more support,
or rest it lightly on your shin, or you could reach for the floor. Looking back up at that left hand if it's comfortable, but if not, you can look forward or look down. If you'd like here, you can turn your palm toward the floor and reach overhead, just extending that triangle. Inhale, bring it back up, and then exhale, hand to the floor. As you inhale, step forward to extended forward fold, and exhale, forward fold. Inhale, step back with the right foot. Coming all the way up, we'll repeat this on the other side, shifting the hip back, reaching the left hand forward, and then bringing it down to Trikonasana. Settling in, wrist above shoulder, above shoulder, above wrist. Breathing. And again, take the top arm. Go ahead and extend it if you'd like, reaching the palm toward the floor. Inhale, bring that up, and exhale, hand to the floor, looking forward. Inhale, step forward, extended forward fold, and exhale, forward fold. Go ahead and hold it for a breath or two here, maybe deepening it by pressing your palms down or by holding your toes or your ankles. With your next inhale, step back again with the left foot, coming all the way up, and this time we'll revolve the triangle. So the hips are going to square toward the front of the mat. The left hand reaches forward, that right hand back. And to start with, maybe coming just this low, really opening the shoulder, reaching the arm. Or maybe coming all the way down, starting to bring the arm straight up, again stacking wrist over shoulder over wrist. Getting that long spine and then twisting. Keeping both feet grounding down into the floor, still breathing. And with your next exhale, bring that hand back down to the floor. Inhale, step forward to extended forward fold, and exhale, forward fold. Inhale, step back with the right foot, coming all the way up, getting ready to revolve it on this side, turning the hips forward, reaching the right hand forward, and then down. Left arm stretches up. And from there, exhale, bring the hand down. Inhale, step forward, extended forward fold. Exhale, forward fold, and again, holding it right here, nice and low, relaxing those shoulders and the head. Going a little more deeply into it, if that's comfortable for you. Steady breath. Good. Now from here, we're going to crouch down onto our heels. So if you have any ankle issues or knee issues, maybe we skip this. Just come back to a child's pose or back to your forward fold. And when we get our feet under us here, when we're sitting down, we're going to open our knees up wide. So we're coming up to sit tall on our heels here. Knees are opening. Heart is lifted back flat. And we can take our hands to our knees, palms up. Find your balance here, your stability, and just breathe. Good. Now we'll take our hands to the floor and come into this arm balance. So if you have any wrist issues or maybe shoulder issues, again, we might want to skip this. Otherwise, we'll place our hands here, fingers spread wide. And remember, we don't have to make this happen today. So to start with, we bring our knees up high toward our armpits. And if you can get them all the way up here on your shoulder, feel free to do that. Otherwise, mine have to rest more on my triceps, so we'll make that work. So with your fingers spread wide, start to shift your weight forward. Get your weight transferring into your hands without pushing off or forcing it. So just let it slowly happen. Maybe you lift one foot, then the other. And maybe you let both feet float up. And from here, those knees are squeezing in. We're breathing still. We're using the entire hand to balance. Core is engaged. And feel free to come out of that when you need to. Let your wrists rest. If you'd like to continue working on it a little bit, go ahead, come back into it. And as you're ready, we'll work our way back to a child's pose. And here on your inhale, come forward to a plank or kneeling plank, and exhale, lower all the way down to the floor. We'll reach our hands behind us here, and if you can clasp them, let's do. Legs squeezed together, we'll come to Sharpasana, lifting the legs up, reaching those hands back, and we're holding here, palms facing each other, looking down at the floor in front of the mat, and breathing, breathing. And exhale, let that go. Rest the left side of your face down. Let's bring our arms up like goalposts and then slide that right knee up as well. And from here, we're going to take one Brahmari breath. So that's the honeybee breath. As we exhale, we're going to do it on a humming sound. So we'll inhale together and then exhale, hum as long as you can using that full exhale. So here, inhale. The Brahmari breath is very balancing, calming for the body. Let's slide our right leg back, nice and easy. We'll come back to Sharpasana a second time, this time lacing the fingers the other way. As you're ready, let's lift that up, legs squeeze together, hands reach back. Crown of the head moves forward, away from your toes. Still holding, still breathing, still squeezing those legs. Every inhale, see if you can lift a little higher, just see if it's there. A lot of times we start to lose it on the exhale, so keep lifting, lifting, and then try to maintain during that full exhale. Good, next out breath, let's lower down, right side of the face down, arms like goalposts, Left leg slides up, and we'll take another Brahmari breath here.
So inhale.
Good. Let your left leg straighten again. Bring your hands back under your shoulders and squeeze your elbows in. Using that tricep strength, lift up through a plank or a kneeling plank and come back once again to child's pose. From here, we'll roll up and come to sitting. And we'll move into Gomukhasana, or the cow's face pose. So we can do this a few ways depending on the flexibility in your hips. So we can cross our legs just like that. You could also stack your shins one on top of the other. That's a little more intense, but not quite as intense as bringing your knees one on top of the other. So find the version that works for you. If we can get here, that's fine. What can help with this too is sitting up on something. So you can get a block or a pillow and sit on it, and that's going to relieve some of that stretch to make this a little more accessible. So feel free to do that if you'd like. Otherwise, as we get settled, make sure both sit bones stay down on the ground and that we're sitting up tall, breathing into that stretch. Eyes can close. If that right leg is on top, we'll bring the left arm behind and reach the right arm behind the back. See if you can find your fingers. Clasp them together. If that doesn't work, you can always press against your tricep here or hold your elbow. Just try to keep your arm from pushing your head down. We don't want to force the head down. So we want to stay up nice and long. So make sure that elbow is staying away from your head. Settling in here with deep breaths. This is a great place to use a yoga strap or a towel or a belt or whatever you have behind you, and you can hold that strap with each hand and work your hands closer together all the time. Good. Let's gently release our hands here. And if you're feeling plenty of stretch, just stay tall, close your eyes. If you'd like a little more stretch, we're going to lean forward here, just for a couple of breaths. And from there, let's bring it back up tall, and we'll switch our legs. So cross them the other way, stack them the other way, or bring those knees one on top of the other, with the other leg on top. Sitting on both sit bones, keep that hip down. Find all that length in your spine. And again, finding that honesty with your body. So if you're feeling pressure in your ankles or in your knees, we want to back it off a little bit, make it a little gentler. From here, let's take the right arm behind the head and reach the left arm behind your back. See if you can find those fingers. Keep that length in your spine. Keep breathing. Good. From there, we'll release the hands. Bring that down slowly. Stay here if you're finding enough stretch, or start to lean forward a little bit and take those deep, long, slow breaths, and imagine you're sending them right to the place where you feel that tightness, where you feel the most stretch or pressure. Breathe into that space and imagine you're creating more space there. Spine is long. Good, and then work your way back up. We'll unfold the legs here. And let's bring them in front of us, knees still open, and we'll bring our arms underneath the legs. So rest your legs on your forearms or maybe your wrists or even in your palms if that's more comfortable. And we're just going to back ourselves up here, shoulders relaxed until we're balanced between our tailbone and our sit bones. And if you want that extra balance, your toes can always touch down if they need to. Keep the heart lifting forward. And let's let that go, nice and easy. Place the feet on the floor and we'll roll down the spine here with control all the way down. And then tuck the knees in, give yourself a little rock side to side. And if you've got a ponytail right in the middle of your head, let's take that out so the head can lie flat. And we'll bring our legs straight up in the air. And this is a great place to stay. If you have a neck issue, a back issue, a headache, or a cold, it's really important to me that you stay right here. You could also get a block and place it right under your sacrum to lift yourself up a little higher, make it a little more effortless. Otherwise, if you'd like to shoulder stand, keep your arms by your side, keep your nose pointed up, and we'll move the legs toward the body, coming overhead, walking those elbows together, hands to the low back, and then we'll lift the legs up high. When we get here, just make sure it's easy to breathe. It feels comfortable on your neck, your back, and remember to stay looking up. And from here, you could stay or move to plow, halasana, bringing the legs down behind the head here, finding the floor. If they don't touch the floor, see about getting them a block to rest on, or let them float and continue to support your low back here. We don't want to force them to the floor if they're not ready to go, so just find that place that works. Again, checking in with your neck, your back, make sure it's all still comfortable. Take those deep breaths here. And then we'll roll back down the same way we came up, nice and slow with the legs staying very close to your body. And then lower the legs down to the ground. You could keep them straight if your core strength is there and if it feels okay on your back. Otherwise, let them bend first. And we'll come into Matsyasana or fish. So go ahead and sit on your hands, lift up to your elbows and walk those elbows in behind you. From there, we'll slide back
And then lift the heart and let the crown of the head come down. So you're touching the crown of your head on the floor, lifting the heart, the chest comes up, 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 breathing deeply here. This is a great counter pose for that plow and shoulder stand where we're closing off the throat. Here we get to open it up again, so it's really important to do fish after we do halasana and the shoulder stand. And then press into your elbows a little bit just to release your head. You can take your hands out. We'll move our knees back in toward the chest, hug them in gently and just rock a little. From here, let's stretch our arms out to the side. We'll let both knees lower down to the left, finding that twist. You can look back at your right hand if that feels good. And from there, start to really let your body relax. Let gravity take this pose and move you into it. But stay mindful of your breath. Keep your mind right here with your project, with what we're doing. And with control, bring the knees back to center. Let's go the other way. And from there, we'll bring the knees back to center and give yourself a reach here, arms overhead, legs out, a little bit of effort in your entire body. And then bring your arms back to rest by your side, legs slightly apart here for Shavasana. Feel free to take up some space on the floor. We have that space, so spread your limbs out a little bit. Keep those palms faced up, feet falling open to the side, let your eyes close. Shoulders away from the ears. And go through your body to see that you're relaxing all these muscles. So double check those places where we hold a little bit in the hips, in the belly, in the face. Allow every breath to deepen your relaxation here. Allow every breath to bring your mind focused and still. Away from the past, away from the future, here in this moment with your body, linked by your breath.
deep breath here, the slowest breath you've taken today. Let it out very slowly, completely. Start to move your fingers and toes. And use very little effort to roll to your right. Pausing on that side. Then working your way back to a comfortable seated position. Choosing a position that you can maintain for a couple of minutes. So maybe sitting up on a pillow or a block, maybe straightening a leg or both. Closing the eyes, turning the palms up on the knees here. Allowing that stillness in your body and in your mind. Let's bring our palms together over the heart, giving ourselves a reminder about that honesty, that truth, and taking it with us into the day, into the week, the year, not only in our dealings with other people, but with ourselves on a moment-to-moment basis, finding the honesty, the truth in every moment, the truth about how our bodies feel, about where our emotions stand, about how we want to spend our time. Let's close with the Akhanda Mantra, Om and Three Shantis. Inhale. Om Akhanda Mandala Karam Vyaptam yena chara charam tat padam darshitam yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Thank your body for what it did today. And I thank you for being here with me. Namaste.